Well, I grew up in Buffalo, New York, and I went to Bishop Fallon High School, which was a diocesan high school, but staffed by the Oblates of Mary Immaculate. Now, I have to tell you that how I got to Bishop Fallon was a little interesting. When I graduated from grammar school in 1959, the diocese had just built a new, brand new high school not too far from where I lived. And everybody in my class went to Bishop Turner, the new high school. I went to Bishop Fallon because my older brother had gone there ahead of me and had arranged for me to work in the bookstore so I didn't have to pay tuition. Tuition in 1959 was $70 a year. So for $70, and actually it was about $100 with books and fees and everything, I went to Bishop Fallon, and that's how I met the Oblates. If I had gone to Bishop Turner, I wouldn't be sitting here right now because I don't know what I'd be, but I wouldn't be an Oblate because I would never have met them. And I remember my first year at Bishop Fallon, Father Bob Colfer came up to me. I can still remember in the hall on the first floor and said to me, you know, we're really impressed by you. Now, I found out he told everybody that he was impressed with them. And he invited me to go to what was called Sem Week, which was going to our seminary in Newburgh, New York, our juniorate, and to play seminarian for a week. And we did that. We went to class. We did manual labor. We did recreation. And the scholastics at that time, people like Bill Sheehan, Jim Flavin, Bill Kopp, Joe McNamara, they were our, quote, teachers for that week. And I was just really impressed by these men, you know, and I just decided that this is what I wanted to do. And I went actually a couple years, and then when graduation came, I just moved down to Our Lady of Hope Minor Seminary, and the rest, I suppose, is sort of history. One of the things about a vocation discernment is that they give you lots of time. From the time I entered to the time I was ordained was 9 years. And throughout that 9 years, you know, you're discerning, but the community is also discerning about you. You have to go through this process of being evaluated and invited on. So a lot of times, you know, people I find when they're thinking about a vocation, they think it's all about them. Well, it is about them, but it's also about the community. So sometimes the community affirms you, and which they did for me, and sometimes the community says, well, maybe it's time to look at something else. And so it in a way, once you understand that, it takes a lot of the pressure off you. Because if the community affirms what you're doing, then it's a sign, well, maybe I am on the right track. Where if you, you know, if it's all about you, then you can, doubts can come in and you wonder. But if year after year through a 9-year process, the community is saying, no, we appreciate what you're doing. You appreciate who you are. And in 1972, I was ordained, took vows in 1969. And how many ever years that is later, here I am. Amen.